come to the land of Savior and our Lord, whom I hope and God knows I pray that you are still serving and worshiping every day, and not simply on Sunday. For this is the day that the Lord has made, and we will, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it. For those of you who haven't quite gotten it yet, you are still worshiping. And the historic, look at the screen, Lynch Street Christian Methodist Episcopal Church, located at 2175 John R. Lynch Street, in the historic capital city of Jackson. But we're still making disciples one by one in the 21st century. We're still seeing Christ in everything we do. And look at the last one that everybody is somebody. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for joining us in our hour of power. I'm saying that sincerely because you didn't have to do it. So thank you so much for thanking if not robbing for joining the Lynch Street worship service today. May God bless you and keep you is my prayer, and I hope that you enjoy our hour of power. Be blessed.
Thank you.
up. Thank you, Songbird. Thank you, Baddest Man in the Land. I grew up with Psalm 100, make a joyful noise unto the Lord. All ye land, serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God, for it is he that has made us, and what? Not we ourselves, for we are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his court with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name, for the Lord is good. For the Lord is good. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting and his truth endureth to all generations. Amen. Let us unite in this historic confession of the Christian faith. In whom do we believe? I believe in God, the Father Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, the only Son of our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead and buried. The third day he rose from the dead, he ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From this he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection of the body and life everlasting. Amen. At this time, my brothers and my sisters, we will be led in prayer by our own Reverend Dorothy Longino, who will also lead us in the scriptural readings.
Let us pray. Father, you have been our waymaker. You have been in the midst with us as we go through. Whether those are the valleys or those are the mountains, Lord, you've been our provider. You've been our healer. Lord, and we just say thank you. Lord, we bless your holy name, sweet Father, because we know that without you, none of this could be possible. Lord, continue to be with us no matter what's going on in the world. We must continue to praise and worship you. That's what we were born to do, sweet Father. And Lord, if I had 10,000 tongues, it would not be enough. Sweet Father, continue to be with us. Lord, continue to watch over those that are sick, the bereaved family, sweet Father. Lord, continue to watch over our pastor and his family, and we'll continue to give you all of the praise, all of the honor, and all of the glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. At this time, we'll be reading from the book of Psalm, chapter 40, verse number 5. Many, O Lord, my God, are thy wonderful works which thou hast done, and thy thoughts which are to us, Lord, they cannot be reckoned up in order unto thee. If I would declare and speak of them, they are more than can be numbered. I read from the book of Psalm, chapter 40, verse number 5. New Testament would be coming out of the book, the Gospel of Matthew. Would you please stand? Chapter 6, verses 19 and 20. And it reads, lay not up for yourselves treasures upon earth, where moth and rust doth corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal. But lay up for yourselves treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust doth corrupt, and where thieves do not break through nor steal. I read from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 6, verses 19 through 20.
And now, my brothers and sisters, we will have a selection by the one and only Songbird. Take it away, Songbird.
Thank you.
again, thank you so much, Songbird, and the baddest band in the land. I greet you in the name of Jesus, who is the Christ. He is still our Redeemer. He's still our Liberator. He's still our Savior. And yes, He is our Lord, who I hope, and God knows I pray, that you are serving and you are worshiping Him every day and not simply on Sunday. For this is the day that the Lord has made, and we will rejoice and be glad in it. My brothers and sisters, I want to thank you for what you do in helping the Lynch Street Church. Thank you for your time. Thank you for your tithe. Thank you for your talents. We could not make it without you. And so for those of you who are considering giving, to those who are not members of the church, if you would just look at your screen, there are various ways, as they indicated earlier in our service, that you can give. Once again, it's on the screen if you would like to participate in our offering. For offering, yes it is a part of giving. So I want you to just take a look at it. And Lynch Street, we are the better because of you. For without you, you, and you, we will not be able to put on these kinds of services that the world is able to see. So thank you so very much. I believe that we've had the birthdays for the month of September. And however, we still want to give you a big round of applause for all of the birthdays in September that were shown earlier, as well as the anniversaries. Let's give them a big round of applause. Thank you so very, very much. Our announcements will not be very long today, other than we will be having the fourth Sunday, I believe it is, that we will be having our Mississippi South Regional Usher Program at 3 p.m. Please check your email and govern yourself accordingly, as our very own Sister Patricia Anderson will be as our Usher's President on the regional level. So please support that today at 3 p.m. God bless you now and keep you is my prayer. I also continue to be in prayer for those persons who are sick and shut in, and particularly by all of those persons who've been affected by Hurricane Ida. I know you all are probably saying, oh, I wonder, does he ever come without his teaching hat? But I'm always a teacher preacher. So I just want to let you know, as it relates to hurricanes, season begins on June 1 and it ends on November 30th. I also wanted to share with you, whenever you have a hurricane always starts in Africa and works through the system. It always 100% starts in Africa. It starts in Africa and it works through the waters, and it either goes to the East Coast or then it will go, to the Gulf of Mexico. So just wanted to let you know, it always starts in Africa. So continue to be in prayer for those persons that are affected through Hurricane Ida. God bless you and keep you now. Again, keep your mask on, stay vigilant as it relates to your surrounding. Keep on your mask whenever you have large groups are gathering. May God bless you and keep you is my prayer. This is indeed a pleasure as well as an immense opportunity for me to introduce our preacher of the hour. You already know her. One of the things I try to do, Lynch Street family, is to give our preachers that are part of our family opportunities to preach. And the person of which I speak, she's been around a long time and she really needs no introduction. So therefore, I'm going to introduce the song, and just in case she needs one, introduce the song and present to others one that's been around here, a native of Lynch Street, through the years, the one and only, the Reverend Barbara Martin. Please pray for her as she brings the Word of God. ¶¶
good morning. Songbird, songbird. Sister, girl, you did what you do all the time and what you do best. And that is, you allow the Lord to let you put your foot on it, put your foot in it, and put your foot all around it. So thanks to you and the baddest band in the land. Good morning. This is the day that the Lord had made, and I won't say let us rejoice. I'm going to say we will rejoice and be glad in it one more time. By now, I'm sure that you have figured out that there's nothing or anything that can stop the sharing of the word of God. Amen. Good morning, Pastor, and everybody who's under the sound of my voice. Welcome, and make yourself comfortable and get your Bible, a writing tablet, and something to take notes on or with. Let us pray. Lord God, it's me again. Calm my anxiety. Allow me to keep my mind stayed on you today, Lord God. And we say, come Holy Spirit, Heavenly Dove, speak to our hearts today. Speak to our hearts, we pray. Now may the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be accepted by you, Father God. We love you, and we glorify you, and we just magnify your holy name. Amen. Lord, we're going to be speaking to you today from the subject, having faith in the storms of life. We could say having faith in God through the storms of COVID. Our scripture is taken from Matthew, the 8th chapter, the 23rd and the 27th verse. It's New Living Translation. And you may join me at your, with your phone, on a pad, you know, whatever you have to write on. It says, then Jesus got into the boat and started across the lake with his disciples. And suddenly, a fierce storm struck the lake, with waves breaking into the boat. But Jesus was sleeping. The disciples went and woke him up, shouting, Lord, save us! We are going to drown. Jesus responded, why are you afraid? You have so little faith. And then he got up and rebuked the wind and the waves. And suddenly there was a great calm. The disciples were amazed. Who is this man? They asked. Even the winds and the waves obey him. Praise be to God's holy word. The first four books of the New Testament are Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. And these books tell us about the amazing life of Jesus when he came to the earth. Jesus did so many amazing things that it would have been impossible to write anything or everything down. John 21:25. But these books give us many, many examples of the miracles that Jesus did. In Matthew chapter 8 alone, we read that Jesus healed a man with a terrible skin disease. and it was called leprosy. He healed a paralyzed servant just by speaking. He healed Peter's sick mother and in-law and drove evil spirits out of many people. So doing all these miracles, Jesus' disciples were right by his side. They were witnesses of all the amazing things that he did. And Jesus was careful to explain everything to his disciples. One of our points is that Jesus calmed storms. Jesus taught in a way that no one had ever heard before. That Jesus was God. Jesus brought peace where there had been chaos. John 14:27. Just like he is going to, what he's going to do with this COVID when he's ready, because we know he works in his time and not our time. The Bible tells us that Jesus could easily read the hearts and minds of men. Jesus knew just how afraid the disciples were at that moment. But why would they be afraid? The disciples have been witnesses that Jesus could speak over all illnesses and it would be healed. So why were they so afraid? Just the word paralyzed legs could walk. Just a word, a blind eyes could see. He could cast out evil spirits with a command. Time and time again, the disciples saw Jesus' miracles with their own eyes. But even after seeing all of these miracles, they still were not sure who Jesus was. They did not have faith that he was the Son of God. Jesus wanted faith from his disciples. He wasn't concerned about who was the smartest or who was the strongest or the best seller. Faith in him was all that matters. So Jesus allowed his storm so that disciples could see for themselves that they did not yet have faith in him. Just like the disciples' storm helped them realize that they did not have faith, the trials that they had come through, they saw that they did not have faith. We don't have faith in COVID and Delta variant, and troubles in our lives can help us see how much faith we have. If our first thought in a difficult situation is one of fear, then we lack faith in the solid rock. Jesus was able to save them just from a word and a command. They would not have been afraid of the storm. This is not to say that they would not have awoken Christ, Jesus, to ask him to help them. In fact, that's exactly what they should have done. If they had faith, they would have gone to Jesus with confidence, knowing that he controlled all things. But their absolute fear showed that they did not trust that Jesus could save them. So Luke says that the disciples screamed, "We are going to drown." Let's try to remember that when our storms that we focus on, turn them over to God instead of our storm. Let's try to remember when in our storms to focus on God instead of focusing on our storms. Having faith in the storms of life. Sometimes it's hard to see the blessings for the storm. Sometimes it's hard for us to see the forest for the trees. Sometimes it's hard to imagine the Lord bringing us out of a situation. And faith is the most important part of this story with Jesus and the disciples on the water. So let's look at it for a few minutes. The Bible says that without faith, it is impossible to please God. Hebrews 11:6. But then Hebrews 11:1 says that faith is being sure of things that we can't see. The faith that Jesus spoke of was having complete trust in Jesus, knowing for certain that he is God, being sure that he is in control, being positive that he can do all things, including these viruses. If the disciple had had faith, they would have been certain that Jesus was in control and that we are going through. In our passages of scriptures this morning, we saw Jesus Christ and his disciples getting into a ship to sail across the Sea of Galilee. And while they were sailing across the Sea of Galilee, Jesus and his disciples were met with a great sea storm. I guess comparing to one we saw a couple weeks ago. But that storm rocked that ship back and forth and up and down. Now, there is a lesson for us to learn in this passage of scriptures. The lesson that we can learn is that just because Jesus Christ is the head of your life, just because Jesus Christ is the center of your life, just because Jesus Christ is the Savior and Lord, that does not mean that you are going to be exempt from having some storms in your life. Sometimes in life, it seems as if we are going through this pandemic and hurricanes and all of our troubles and trials and tribulations all alone because the Lord has fallen asleep on us. I'm thinking about the footprint in the sand. And when young man asked Jesus, Jesus, you said you would be with us at all times. But I noticed along my way, my lowest time, I see only one set of footprint. And that's my set of footprint. You was not there. And Jesus said to him, my child, when you saw only one set of footprints, that was my footprint. Because I was carrying you. I was carrying you during that time. And as I said before, I will never, never leave you. You may be going through some storms in your marriage, in your relationship, on your job, young people at school, in your home, in your health, in your finances, or whatever. Just remember, God sees all and He knows all about your situation. He knows about your troubles. But yet, a question is being asked. Why was Jesus fast asleep during that storm? No matter how bad the situation seems, you may find yourself in it. Just remember that Jesus cares. And 1 Peter says in 5:7, he says, casting all your cares upon Him, for He cares for you. We're having faith in the storms of life. Jesus was teaching and healing hundreds of people. And so when He was finally away from the crowds, He went to the back of the boat and laid His head on a cushion and fell asleep. I can imagine somebody being a little afraid of thunder and lightning, being on a boat during a storm especially. And it is very scary. Many of the disciples who were in the boat with Jesus were professional fishermen. And that means that their job was fishing in a boat. They had been in many storms before. And they were frightened. They probably did everything that they knew how to do before waking Jesus up. And by the time they went to Jesus, they were terrified. Matthew 8:25 tells us. So to the disciples' amazement, Jesus only had to speak a few words, and the storm became silent. The wind stopped, and the water was still. And He spoke, and the sea obeyed. And actually, this shouldn't surprise us, because remember, as Bible scholars, that in the beginning, what did God do to create the earth, the light, the stars, and the sun? He spoke Genesis 1:3. And Genesis 1:3 tells us that God said, "Let there be light." And there was light. In the same way, God spoke the earth, the plants, and all the animals into being. And this creator, God, was the same God who was now in the boat with His disciples. As John 1:10 says, His spoken words were so powerful. And there was nothing in nature that could ever disobey His command. The storms, obedient to Jesus' command, gave further proof. When Jesus spoke, people knew that He had authority. Matthew 7:29. He was unlike any other teacher. One day, Jesus was teaching near the Sea of Galilee, and even though it is called a sea, it's actually a big lake. And after teaching a large crowd of people, Jesus instructed His disciples to get into a boat so they could cross the lake. Matthew 8:18. They all needed to get away from the crowds and rest. And several people followed along in their own boats. All of us have storms in our lives, one way or another. But we have a Savior in Jesus Christ who's able to speak to our storms and bring people and peace into our lives. And all you need to do is call on Him and trust Him to calm the storm that is in your marriage, in your home, in your family, in your health, on the job, with your children, at school, or wherever you may be facing your troubles, your trials and tribulation and storms. Call on Jesus and he can work it out. I don't know the nature of the storm you're facing this morning, other than Delta variant, COVID, but I know the one who still walks on the waves. I know that if he'll come, if you'll come bring your needs to him, he will hear you and he will help you this morning. Who knows? He might just show up this morning, trumping on your storms, trumping on COVID and Delta variant. No matter how bad things seem to be, it can get worse, but God has control. So put him on your route, your rugged route, and let him show you how to solve your problems. I can relate to this week. I've experienced some things, and I can relate to the things that some people are going through. And while we were trying to figure it out, God has it already taken care of. And that reminds me of Yolanda Adams with a song, "In the Midst of It All." Yolanda Adams. I've come through many hard trials. I've come through temptations on every hand. Though Satan tries to stop me and to place my feet on sinking sand, through the pain and all of my sorrows, through the tears and all of my fears, the Lord was there to keep me, for he's kept me in the midst of it all. Not because I've been so faithful, not because I've always obeyed. No, it's not because I trusted him to be with me all the way, but it's because he loves me so dearly. He was there to answer my calls. He was there always to protect me, for he's kept me in the midst of it all. I've come through many hard trials, through temptations on every hand, though Satan tried to stop me and to place my feet on sick and sand. I can say that all day, over and over. But Jesus loves me dearly. He was there to answer my calls this week. There's always to protect me, for he's kept me in the midst of it all. No, 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 he never left me, and he never let me fall. Oh, yes, he will protect you, for he's kept me in the midst of it all. Oh, yeah, he kept me. Lord, 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 he kept me. Yes, he did. He kept me. Lord, and if you are ready today to bring Jesus in your heart and your life, look, keep looking, and we have a message waiting for you.
Oh,
lighthouse shines, it shines for those that are lost. And it leads them in the right direction to safe ground. We have that friend that's there to lead, that's there to guide us through life situations. Won't you take his hand? Won't you join his hand? Open up your hearts and receive him. John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life." Won't you believe on him today? There's a number that's on your screen. If you need prayer, somebody will give you a call. Won't you come? Won't you come?
Appreciate the word. What a word from the woman of God. If you don't mind, let's give God praise for him tonight. What a wonderful, wonderful word. May God continue to bless you, Reverend Martin, and keep you is my prayer. Same to you, my brothers and sisters. Let's lift up each other during this pandemic. In God's time, Kairos, God's time, God will lift this pandemic, preferably we see each other face to face with ourselves. With that assurance, the Lord bless you, keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you, be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up the light of his countenance upon each of you and give you peace and give you peace. And give you peace and give you peace. Give you peace, give you peace, and give you peace. Right now, and amen. I bless you, keep you now, in my prayer. Wonderful Sunday. Remember to mask up when you go around. Wash your hands. Wash your hands. Keep your 6 feet distance. And we'll all come out of the way of the grace of God and the finishing line. Have a wonderful Sunday.